Good morning, everybody. Jeff Carter here, and it's just about sunrise now. And I'm on the dark side. Dun, 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 dun. And just come off Sukhumvit. Don't know what Sawyer come down, and I'm lost already. But I love it. It's called mooching. And just look where I found now. It looks beautiful. Have a look at this. Yeah, morning sunrise and the morning dew on all the trees and grass. Look at that. So today we are going on a magical mystery tour on the dark side, and we're just going to have a drive round and see what we can see. So come on, let's go. Right, I think we're on Soi Khao Noi now. I could be wrong, I normally am, but I'm out mooching. I'm going to get lost today. There we go, we're going down there now. Right, I've just come about a mile down the road and I'm feeling a bit peckish. And it's only about 7 a.m, 7:15. And I've just spotted these people over here now, street vendors doing morning food. And I fancy something like mooping, which is like the barbecue pork. This lady might be doing them here, I don't know. Yep, she's got them here. We're gonna have a couple of mooping just to keep us going. And then we're going to carry on down the road here. So I'll just show you them now. Yeah, look. Beautiful. Look. Wow. Look, lovely. All fresh. Two mooping, please. Ooh, look at them. What a great way to start the day. And where you'd ever see one of these food vendors, you always see a nice little dog and then his mate. Look, they've come because they know that people like us feed them. They're not daft, you know. All right then. Oh yeah, he's scratching my leg now, he wants some food. Two more please, mooping. I've got to get the dogs one, and I can't leave them hungry like that. Oh, what am I like? I'm a soft touch, aren't I? Anyway, that's what it's all about. Come here, kid. Thank you. Thank you. Right, dogs, it's yours now. Here you go, lad. Here you go, kid. There you go. Look, they won't leave me alone now. Look at them, I've got best mates forever, look. Go on then, kids. One more. Go on. See you later, boys. Take care. Beep, beep. Hey, how funny with them dogs then. They won't leave me alone. Couldn't even eat mine. Mooping. So I've had to drive down the road out the way. It was following me everywhere. But if you've never tried these, look at them. They're gorgeous. They're only 10 baht each, about 25 pence. And they're barbecued pork, and they've got lots of flavour, and they melt in your mouth. They're absolutely gorgeous. You'll see them by loads of roadside vendors early in the morning, and they're gorgeous. So I'm going to have this now, and we'll carry on down the road and see what we can see. Delicious. Well, folks, it's about 7:35 a.m. now, and the sun's coming up. And I tell you what, it's getting warm already. And after yesterday, I nipped out for some fruit. I got some mango and some pineapple. And the heavens opened for about 2 hours. I got drowned. But today, it looks like blue skies everywhere. And even at this time of the morning now, it's getting hot. But we're having a great mooch already, and I'm really enjoying it, and I hope you are as well. We're just going to keep going and see what we can see today. Okay, I'll get back on the bike then, shall I? Shall I? Well, I've just pulled over on the road now because I've just seen this old temple here. It looks great. We're going to have a look at that in a minute. But can you hear them in the background? The cockerels are crowing. That's how early in the morning it is. So let's have a look at this temple, shall we? looks like this is a very, very old temple. You know, it doesn't look very open to me. And I was walking down there just, and loads of barking dogs. And I don't know whether they're caged up or whether they're loose, but I'm not chancing it. But there's about 1,000 chickens and cockerels here, it's unbelievable. Right, I'm going to get back on the bike before I get my leg bit off. Okay. Right, I've just seen another temple. And this one's a white one and it's all glistening in the sun. But have a guess what? They've got me again. This might as well be called Soi Sunak. It's full of dogs. I've seen about 100 already. Here, I'd have a look at my little mate here. Look at him. Don't leave me alone. And then the other one's here. Look. Look at him. Oh. They must be hungry, you know. People mustn't be feeding them. Oh, it's a bit early. Would it be in a temple? I think they would anyway. But let's have a little look round here because it's stunning. He won't leave me alone. He's like a little lap dog. Who let the dogs out? Woof, woof, who let the dogs out? Can't get rid of him. Right, let's have a look at this wonderful temple. Look at that for craftsmanship. Wow. Well, there you go. I think you've seen enough temples for one day now. We're going to carry on looking around and see what else we can see. Now, this is called the dark side. I wonder why it's called the dark side. If you know, please let me know in the comments below, because I was told that years ago there was no street lights. And so when you come out of Pattaya across Sukhumvit Road, it was all in darkness. And that's why they called it the dark side. Or was it because it was something a little more sinister? I don't know, it's hearsay, but somebody out there must know. So if you know, leave it in the comment section below. I'd love to find out the truth, why it's called. Dun, 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 dun. Right, we're gonna go looking for something brand new now. I promise, keep watching, no more temples. Well, folks, I got well and truly lost just. End up nearly on the motorway to Rayong. So I've come all the way back down and I've just stopped off now for a bottle of water at the 7-Eleven. I'm trying to find the big lake. Can't remember where it was. All these roads look the same. Anyway, I asked a woman in there. None of them speak English. Well, they wouldn't, would they? Because they're Thai. We're on the dark side. Anyway, I'm going to have a bottle of water and I think it's behind me. If not, it's just a magical mystery tour yet again. Getting hot now though, you've got to keep hydrated, and that is a bargain at just 6 baht. So we're going to go down there now and try and find the lake. I've been there before, I don't know what's wrong with me, I just can't remember which road it's on. Okay, let's try again. Well, folks, as you can see behind me, I made it to the lake eventually. I come out of that road before and I was way past the floating market, and then I ended up past Pattaya railway station on the way back to Bangkok. Anyway, after driving round, I thought I'm not going to give up. I'm going to find the lake if it kills me, and it nearly did. So have a look at the lake. Not much going on. A couple of fishermen here, there and everywhere, and then that's about it. So we're going to have a drive round the back end there now, and we're going to find somewhere to have maybe a Coca-Cola or a coffee, and a quick bite to eat. by the lakeside on the main road. I know there's a few places round here. So we'll plonk down, get some food, and then we'll see what happens. I was going to come down here on my motorbike, and I thought, no. After crashing one in Koh Tao, I went that steep, it was like that, and it just stopped and went over. So I'm not doing that again. So back to the main road now, and we'll try and find somewhere to settle down for 5 minutes. Well, that was a stroke of luck. I've just come up from the lake, went about 500 yards down the road, and I've seen it. Paddy's Irish Pub and Grill. And they're bound to do a nice breakfast or something like that. So that's where we're going for the food, over there. So let's have a look at the menu when we get there. Whew, it's a hot one. Right, let's go inside. Oh, it's nice and cool in here. Wow. Got all the sports TVs on, the nice bar. And then a lovely restaurant area, look. So I think we'll find a table and sit down and get the menu. Hey, it's nice in here, you know. Right, the menu's arrived. Let's have a little look what we're going to have. Right, I've not had one since I've been here in Thailand, so I think I'll go for the full English breakfast at 275 baht. I'm a big believer, mate, and you only get what you pay for. This is a lovely cup of coffee here, with your brown sugar, your white sugar. And the knife and fork just turned up in a proper cloth napkin. Well, here it is, folks. We've got baked beans, we've got black pudding, two hash browns, we've got the mushrooms, we've got bacon, tomato, we've got a curly sausage, and we've got two fried eggs, and a round of toast with butter and marmalade, and a nice coffee. Agree, it's a little bit more expensive than some places in Pattaya, but it's quality. All fantastic. They're not them processed sausages, this is a real proper made one, fried eggs, big piece of bacon, nice big thick tomato, and HP again, fantastic. So I'm gonna tuck into this now and let you know what it tastes like. But it looks absolute ding-dong, Avon calling. It looks absolutely fantastic. Bit of salt and pepper. And away we jolly well go. Try the sausage first. Right, I'm going to carry on eating all this now. You don't want to watch me eat every little bit of it, do you? It'll be a bit boring, that. And we'll do the scores on the doors. It looks fabulous, it tastes fabulous, but what's going to be the score out of 10? And I'd like you to put your score down, what you think it was worth, on the comment section below. But I'll tell you something, this is a very, very good breakfast. Right, folks, what did you think of the breakfast? Leave it in the comments below. I'm going to give you a rundown now. The sausage was bent, and we all know who likes a bent sausage, don't we? The Matt Master. Well, I'll tell you what, Matt Master, that sausage was 10 out of 10, mate. And then we've got the beans. There was Heinz baked beans. We had the bacon, no fat on it, like you normally get. You know, I don't know where they get them pigs from with all that fat on. That was bob on. The hash browns, fantastic. Tomato, fresh. Mushrooms, brilliant. Black pudding, I don't eat black pudding, but it was there if you wanted it. I don't think of, oh, and two fried eggs. And I said, can you make them runny so I could dip my toast in? Fantastic. The only downside I got was the coffee wasn't full enough. I like a large coffee, me. And it was a bit half full, the cup. But they did have HP sauce, so yeah. So what we're gonna give it score-wise out of 10, he says, beep, beep. I think I'm gonna give it, just because the coffee wasn't full to the top, and I had to order a Coca-Cola. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10, because that food is fantastic. I know you can get cheaper versions across the way, but that was well worth the ride. And it's called Paddy's Irish Pub and Grill, and they do all types of food. And it's a belting barn, it's all well stocked, nice and cool in there, and the staff are fantastic. So yeah, I'm going to give it a big fat 9. What would you give it? Put it in the comments below. Okay folks, that's it now. It's a long ride back to where I'm living. And it's about 10:45 now in the morning, and it's getting really warm. So I'm going to say, if you enjoyed the movie, give us a thumbs up. If you didn't, give us a thumbs down. And don't forget to leave your comments below, obviously. And if you're new to the channel, why not subscribe, and then you can see all the next movies coming up. So subscribe and hit the little bell, because we love it when you do that. And you all know now, if you're a regular viewer, exactly what I'm going to say. All together now, are we ready? 1, 2, 3. And the main thing is, keep smiling.